Record. Okay. So doing the same similar stuff as last week with crow and transitioning from headstand and jumping out. If it's a very big thing from crow to headstand back to crow jumping out, it's a lot. So if it doesn't happen today, no stress. Do what's comfortable for you and your body, and remind yourself that this is a practice, this is a journey. It will happen in time. Just be patient with it. I was gonna say something else, but now I can't remember, so I guess it's not that important. We're gonna start in a seated position. If you have a block or something that you would like to sit on to prop your hips up, you're welcome to sit on a block. I'm going to do this. Okay. So we'll be moving, we'll do some similar things as we did last week, but we'll also be moving just a little slower because I want to work with this idea of having patience with our practice and patience with ourselves and our bodies. So you might find that as we move a little bit slower and we hold poses for a little bit longer, your mind also starts to get impatient. So thinking of focusing on your breath and reminding yourself that although we are holding them for poses for longer, we're not going to be there forever. We will move on, I promise. So let's start with your palms can face up. If you want to receive a little extra energy, palms can face down. Oh, wait, I remembered what I wanted to say. Hold on. We're going to be doing what's called shoulder cars. A cars stands for controlled articulated rotation. It's a movement modality that's called FRC, functional range conditioning. And with cars, this controlled articulated rotation, you only want to move one joint or one body part. And today we're going to be working with shoulder cars. So be aware when we're moving and rotating our shoulders that your ribs aren't getting involved, that your head isn't getting involved, or that your spine isn't moving, that you're only moving your scapula, your shoulder blades. And we'll be doing it in this position. We've done it in crescent lunge a few times, but we'll be doing it in plank and then also in downward facing dog. So it's going to feel, in each position we're in, it's going to feel a little strange, but we'll do it seated first so that you can really feel. But just keep in mind that we only want our shoulder blades to move. No ribs, no head, no elbows bent, only your shoulder blades. Okay, done with that. So palms can face up if you want to receive a little extra energy. Palms can face down if you want to receive some grounding energy. And if it feels comfortable, you can close your eyes or you can keep your gaze soft, low and soft on your mat or the space in front of you. Just take a moment to notice where your body is, notice your breath. Notice if you're holding any tension somewhere that you might not need, maybe in your jaw or your face. And take a big inhale through your nose. Exhale through your mouth. Inhale through your nose. Exhale through your mouth. One more inhale through your nose. Exhale through your mouth. And inhale through your nose. Seal your lips, exhale through your nose. Start to connect to your ujjayi breath. Again, inhale through your nose. Exhale through your nose. And continue inhaling and exhaling through your nose. Allow your ujjayi breath to be your guidance throughout your practice today. Let it help remind you of patience. If you notice your mind wanders, refocus on your ujjayi breath and this intention of patience. Sometimes when we're on our yoga mat and our mind does wander, we start to get a little frustrated that we're not, you know, in the moment, we're not meditating, we're letting our mind wander. And that's okay. It's kind of what our mind was made for, to think. So if it happens, try not to get frustrated. Just be patient with yourself and know that over time, the more we practice and use this, as I like to say, meditation muscle, it will get stronger. We just need to have patience. And start to invite any movement that feels comfortable. If you want to take some circles in your neck, if you want to take some circles in your shoulders, we've done this in the past. If you want to hold onto your knees and kind of arch and contract your spine, or if you want to just bring some gentle movement into your spine, doesn't need to have a name to it specifically. Or maybe you feel like you need stillness, you've been moving a lot and your body needs to be still. We'll take one more breath here. And then slowly flutter your eyes open if they were closed. And then we're going to stay in a seated position. Arms are going to come forward and start to make fists. So you create a little bit more tension in your arms. Remember, we don't want to bend our elbows. We want to keep our arms straight. So before we do our scapula cars, our shoulder circles, lift your shoulders up towards your ears and press your shoulders down your back. Lift your shoulders up towards your ears. Press your shoulders down your back. One more time. Notice if your neck or your ribs or anything moves, press down. And then come neutral. Punch your arms forward. Feel your shoulder blades, your scapula pull apart from one another. And then pinch your shoulders together. This one's really easy to arch your ribs. Keep your core engaged. Push forward and pinch. Once more, punch forward, yikes, and pinch. Good, and then come center. We'll do three forward and three back. So lift your shoulders up towards your ears. Roll your shoulders forward. Slide your shoulders down your back. Pinch your shoulders together and lift again. Twice more, forward, down, back, and pinch one more. And you want your arms will move forward and back, but imagine they're on the shelf. So try not to lower or lift your arms. And then the next time you get your shoulders up towards your ears, pause here and reverse. Pinch your shoulders together, slide your shoulders down your back, punch forward, lift up, pinch together, slide down, punch forward, once more, up, back, down, and forward. Relax your arms for a second, pause. Palms can face up or down, just notice how your shoulders feel. So when we do these cars now in different positions, you might feel, if you feel any pain, think of backing off, like you're going over a speed bump. You're gonna back off for a second, you'll go over that pain, and then you can push the range of motion. So with these shoulder cars, you wanna try and make as big of a circle as possible without any pain and without any compensation of moving your body. So shift forward into your tabletop position. Spread your fingers nice and wide. Allow the tops of your feet to rest down. Inhale, cow pose. Drop your belly down, look up. Slide your shoulders down your back. Pause here and take a few breaths. Zip your belly button in towards your spine. Think of lengthening and pulling your heart forward. One more, inhale. Exhale, cat pose. Curve and round. Let your head relax. Pause here and take a few breaths. Use your lower abdominals to pull in towards your spine. Feel how that helps open up some space in your lower spine. Inhale, cow pose. Pull your heart forward. Energize your wrists back towards your knees. Exhale, cat pose. Inhale, cow. Exhale, cat. Once more, inhale, cow. Exhale, cat. Hold your cat spine, round your spine. This time, tuck your toes and hover your knees off of your mat. Keep your knees as close to the mat as possible, but pull your knees towards your wrists. Really push into your hands. Feel the space between your shoulders puff up. Hold for one more inhale. And then exhale, lower your knees down. Keep your toes tucked. Inhale, cow pose. Exhale, cat pose, round. And then inhale, hover your knees off of your mat. Strong exhale. Lower your knees down once more, just like that. Inhale, cow pose. Exhale, cat, round your spine. and then hover your knees off of your mat just barely and hold and breathe. Good, and then slowly lower your knees down. You can untuck your toes. Take a couple of breaths on your own and any movement that feels comfortable. If you wanna move your ribs in circles, if you wanna circle your shoulders or circle your head, whatever feels comfortable for you. If you wanna move through cat-cow once again, you can. And then we're gonna come back into your neutral tabletop position. We're gonna do our shoulder cars from this position. If you have a yoga block, you can put your yoga block on your back as kind of a tool to make sure you're not moving your spine. Because if you move your spine a lot, then the yoga block will fall off. You can also imagine you have a glass of water or a yoga block on your back. So spread your fingers nice and wide. Lift your shoulders up towards your ears. Roll your shoulders forward. Slide your shoulders down your back, pinch your shoulders together, roll your shoulders up, forward, back, or excuse me, down, and then back. And again, lift up, roll forward, down, and back. Once more, lift up, roll forward, down, and back. Lift up, hold it here, and then reverse, rolling back, slide down, press your hands into the ground, and then roll up, back, down, and forward. Go a few more times on your own, rolling backwards, two more to be exact. And you might notice that one arm feels a little different than the other, or one direction feels a little different than the other, and that's okay. When you're done with your last two, if you have your yoga block on your back, you can place that down. Good. And then we're gonna do a little wrist activation. So spread your fingers nice and wide. Press your fingertips down into the ground and lift, reach your shoulders as far forward as you can. Lift in your lower abdominals and hold it here. Really press your fingertips into the ground. Take a few more breaths. Notice if there's any bend in your elbows. Good. And now start to lift your fingertips off of the ground. They might not actually come up, but try and lift your hands off of the ground and then start to rock back. And then you'll find it is a little easier to lift your hands off of the ground. Keep rocking back so your whole palm comes off of the ground, but you're still trying to pull your fingers back towards your wrists, or excuse me, back towards your forearm, flexing in your wrist. And again, lean forward, press your fingertips down, reach your shoulders as far forward as you can. Arms stay straight. Hold for 3, 2, and one, start to lift your fingertips off of the ground and start to rock back, and you'll feel that it's a little easier to reach back into your wrist flexion and reach your hands off of the ground. So the whole time you're trying to keep the angle of your wrist the same. Good, and then one more time, reach forward. So if doing this correctly, you'll feel a burn in the front of your wrist and your forearms. Start to reach your shoulders maybe a little farther than before. Good, now look down at the angle that your wrist is making. Start to lift your fingertips up, and as you rock back, the goal is to try and keep that same angle the same. Reach back, feel the burn in the front of your wrist, keep flexing your palms, reaching back, and then sink all the way down to your heels. You can shake your wrists out. You can interlace your fingers and take some figure eights. So again, hopefully we felt a nice burn and activation in our hands and our wrists. Sometimes I just kind of like to squeeze the flesh around my hands and my forearms. Okay, so we're gonna come into a plank to do our shoulder cars in plank. It is a little bit more challenging because there's less of your body on the mat. So if you feel like you need to drop your knees down so you can feel the same circular pattern of your shoulders, that's totally fine. You can rest onto your knees, just giving you an option. So spread your fingers wide, step back into your plank position. And again, if you feel like you need to lower your knees down for support, you're always welcome to. Lift your shoulders up towards your ears, roll your shoulders forward, slide your shoulders down your back, pinch your shoulders together, forward, down, back, once more up, forward, down, back, lift up, hold, and pinch back, down, forward, up, back, down, once more, up, back, down, and forward. Hold your plank position. Core stays nice and tight. Keep pressing your hands into the ground. Hold for 4. Hold for 3. Hold for two. Inhale. Exhale, downward facing dog. Try not to move your hands and your feet closer towards one another. Pull your ribs together. Zip your core nice and tight. Try not to arch in your back. Ribs stay tight. And if you want to bend your knees one at a time, you can. If you want to shake your head yes and no, release some tension in your upper spine, you can. Good. And then inhale, bend both knees, gaze forward. Slowly travel to the top of your mat into your forward fold. Let your head relax, let your arms relax. You can have a soft bend in your knees if you'd like. Take one more breath here and exhale. Inhale, bend your knees, look at your belly button, relax your arms, slowly roll up one vertebrae at a time. Inhale, mountain pose, reach your arms high, pause here. In your mountain pose, I'm gonna bend my knees, I'm gonna lower down so you can see my hands. Flex your palms and try and pull your palms up towards the ceiling. Your shoulders will lift up and at the same time, push your feet into the ground. So the more you push down into the ground and the more you press up, you'll feel a nice lift in your side body and your ribs. Find a length in your spine. One more inhale. And then exhale, relax your arms forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift, find length in your spine as you pull your chest forward. Exhale, low lunge, step your left foot back, right foot stays forward. Pause here. If you want to have your blocks underneath your palms to help elevate your chest, you're welcome to. Ooh. You can also tent up your fingertips or drop your knee down if you're looking for a variation. Whatever variation you take, think about pulling your thigh bones away from one another. So even if your knee is down, keep pulling and stretching your left knee back behind you. A few more breaths here. Extend the crown of your head forward. Inhale, plant your hands down. Exhale, plank pose. Three breaths here. Strong inhale. Strong exhale through your nose. Think of puffing the space between your shoulders up towards the ceiling to really activate your arms. Good, one more inhale. And exhale. Inhale, shift your shoulders as far forward as you can. Hold it here, really press your fingertips into the ground. So you should feel that you're barely on your toes because you're pushing so far forward. And we're gonna slowly lower down for four. Hug your elbows close to your body. Three, two, and lower all the way onto your stomach. Untuck your toes. Inhale, cobra pose. Pull your chest forward. Pause here and take a few breaths. Scoop your tailbone under so your low back stays nice and long. Imagine you're gripping into your mat, like you're gonna slide your mat back behind you. That push and pull will help open up your heart and reach your chest farther forward. One more inhale. And then exhale, downward facing dog. Tuck your toes and press your hips up and back. Good. So press your hands into your mat so much that your shoulders lift up towards your ears, very similar to what you found in your mountain pose when you were flexing your palms and lifting your arms up towards the ceiling. And then slide your shoulders down your back. Puff your shoulders up, press into your hands, and slide your shoulders down your back. Reach up, slide your shoulders down your back. Once more, reach up, slide your shoulders down your back. Good, inhale, shift your weight to your right foot. Exhale, low lunge, step your left foot forward. Pause here and take a few breaths. And again, your choice. Tent up your fingertips, hands on your block, drop your knee down, whatever feels comfortable for you. Maybe your body's asking for a variation that I didn't offer. listen to your body. Your body is the most important driver here. Connecting your ujjayi breath with your practice. Two more breaths here. Inhale, exhale, forward fold. Step to the top of your mat, let your head relax. Inhale, halfway lift to reset your spine. Exhale, fold. Inhale, bend your knees, look at your belly button. Exhale, slowly roll up one vertebrae at a time. Inhale, mountain pose, reach your arms high. Flex your palms and reach your arms up towards the ceiling. Feel the lift of your shoulders. Feel how that can lift your ribs as well and find a little more length in your spine. One more inhale. Exhale, forward fold. Lift your tailbone as you let your head float down. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, low lunge. Step your right foot back. Left foot stays forward. This time, drop your right knee down. Release the top of your foot. Inhale, crescent moon. Reach your arms high. Pause here and take a few breaths. Soften in your shoulders, tuck your tailbone under as you guide your hips forward. Feel the same lift that you just found in mountain pose without lifting your arms up towards the ceiling. See if you can find the lift of your ribs as you soften your shoulders down. Good, you have the option to grab your right wrist and pull over to the left side if you want. One more inhale. And then exhale, plank pose. Press your hands down, step your left foot back. Inhale, pull your shoulders as far forward as you can. Exhale, hold. Inhale. Exhale, lower down for four. Three, elbows hug close. Two and one. Inhale, cobra pose. Pull your chest forward. Slide your shoulders down your back. One more inhale. Exhale, downward facing dog. Tuck your toes and press your hips up and back. Good. So now here in our downward facing dog, we're going to try and roll, go through our scapula cars. It's going to feel very strange and you might not be able to get a big range of motion, and that's okay. I'm going to let you do this on your own time because it is kind of like a pat the head, rub the belly exercise, and I don't want you to feel like you have to stick with me. I personally feel it's easier to roll backwards. So you're gonna do three reps in each direction. So if you wanna start with backwards first, that's what I feel is easiest. Try to minimize the movement of your head, the movement of your ribs, and then you'll go three forward. Oh man, forward always feels so strange to me. But that's okay, be patient. Maybe you need to go a little slower. When you're done with three and three, you can stretch back into your downward facing dog. Nice. And again, the movement might be much smaller than you did on your other variations, and that's okay. Good. Inhale, shift your weight to your left foot. Exhale, low lunge, step your right foot forward. Inhale, crescent moon, drop your knee down, reach your arms high, pause here. Scoop your tailbone under and press your hips forward. Lift your ribs away from your hips as you soften your shoulders down. Option to grab your left wrist and stretch over to your right. If you did so on the first side. One more inhale. And then exhale, plank pose. Press your hands down, step your feet back. So we're gonna do a couple of lunges. You're gonna shift your weight to your right foot. Exhale, left foot on the outside of your left hand. Inhale, plank. Exhale, right foot on the outside of your right hand. Inhale, plank. Exhale, left. Inhale, plank. Exhale, right. Inhale, plank. Exhale, left. Inhale, plank. Exhale, right. Inhale, plank. Last time, exhale, left. Hold it. Inhale. Exhale, goddess. Or excuse me. I can't speak. Shift forward into your squat. I was going to call it goddess squat, but that's not correct. Malasana squat. Elbows on the inside of your knees. If you want to sit on a block, you can. If you're really flexible, careful that you don't sit down and let gravity kind of take over here. Activate your muscles, lift the crown of your head up. Hold it here for two more breaths. One more inhale. And then exhale, forward fold, lift your hips, heel toe your toes underneath your hips. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, yogi's choice, walk, step, or jump back into your chaturanga. Grip your fingertips down, whatever option you're going to take. Inhale, upward facing dog. Pause here for a few breaths. If you want to look over your shoulder one at a time, if you want to take some circles in your neck, just keep pressing into your hands. Inhale. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, lift your right leg up towards the ceiling. Exhale, right knee to right elbow. Pause here. Really pull your lower abdominals in. Keep pressing your hands into the ground. Lift the space between your shoulders up towards the ceiling. Remember when I said we were going to hold poses for a long time today? If it hasn't already started for you, it's starting now. Keep breathing. If you need to rest your toe on your right toes on the ground for a little break and then come back, you're welcome to. See if you can squeeze your right heel towards your butt if your toes are not on your mat. One more inhale. Hold for your exhale. Inhale, right leg high. Lift your right toes up towards the ceiling. Exhale, low lunge. Pull your knee towards your chest. Step forward. Inhale, crescent lunge. Reach your arms high. Pause here and take a few breaths. Scoop your tailbone under. Soften your shoulders down your back. And as you sit in the pose, see how you can deepen the pose. Can you continuously push your heel back behind you? Maybe you can get a little deeper tuck of your pelvis. Maybe you can bend your right knee a little farther forward. Be patient. Use your ujjayi breath to help quiet your mind and calm your body. Inhale. Exhale, airplane arms. Your arms reach back and shift your body weight forward. Really press through your left toes. You might even be able to lift up onto your left toes so there's more weight on your right leg. Find a nice long spine. Pull your navel in. One more inhale. Exhale, warrior two. Cartwheel your hands open. Pause here. Pull your arms away from one another. Pull your thighs away from one another. Soften in your shoulders. Use your ujjayi breath as you gaze over your front fingers. And same thing as I mentioned in crescent lunge, how can you deepen the pose? Can you push more into your feet? Can you pull your right knee farther forward? Can you press your hips farther forward? Maybe pull your arms away from one another. Inhale, star pose. Turn your heels in, face sideways as you reach your arms nice and high. And then exhale, interlace your fingers behind you. I'm gonna turn to face the back so you can see a little differently. And then pull your knuckles back behind you. Pull your palms together or as close as they can be and get a little arch in your spine. So pull your chest up towards the ceiling as you engage your lower abdominals. Keep pulling down. Hold for one more inhale. And then exhale, wide-legged forward fold with a chest expansion. So keep your arms reaching overhead as you let your head float down. Relax in your neck. Keep trying to pull your palms together. Let your shoulders relax. Hold for one more inhale. And then exhale, slowly relax your arms down. Good. Inhale, plant your hands underneath your shoulders. And then turn sideways again. Hands are right underneath your shoulders. Press your fingertips into the ground. And then start to shift your weight into your hands, maybe releve and lift your heels off of the ground. Feel your lower abdominals engage. And then place your heels back down. Just like we did in the plank pose, shift your shoulders as far forward as you can. Lift up into your toes. Lift up into your lower abdominals. Think of scooping your abdominals in, lower down. Once more, inhale, shift, pull your weight forward over your wrists. One more inhale, and then exhale, lower down. Inhale, star pose, rise and turn your heels in. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, reverse warrior, pause here. Soften your right shoulder down your back. Pull your right knee forward. Pull your right ribs away from your hips. See if you can press a little bit more weight into all four corners of your feet. One more inhale. Exhale, low lunge, cartwheel your hands down. Yogi's choice, you can move through a flow or step straight to downward facing dog. Nice, good yogis. Good, we'll all meet in a downward facing dog. Inhale, lift your left leg high. Exhale, left knee to left elbow, hold it here. Shift your shoulders as far forward as you can. Squeeze your heel towards your butt. Press your fingertips down. Really pull the shoulders, the space between your shoulders up towards the ceiling. So you're feeling a lot of tension in your arms and you're feeling a lot of tension in your core. Few more breaths here. Remember, if you need to tap your toes down for a little break, you're welcome to. If not, keep squeezing your heel towards your butt so you feel your hamstrings engage as well. Use your ujjayi breath. One more inhale. One more exhale. Inhale, left leg high. Exhale, low lunge. Inhale, crescent lunge. Reach your arms high. Pause here and take a few breaths. As you start to settle into the pose, notice how one side feels a little different than the other. Maybe it's easier to get a little deeper front knee bend. Maybe it's easier to push your back foot behind you. Maybe you just feel a little bit more comfortable on this side. That's okay. Maybe you feel a little less comfortable on this side. That's okay too. Inhale. Exhale, airplane arms. Your arms reach back behind you. Pull your chest forward. Engage your abdominals as you push your right heel back behind you. See if you can pour a little bit more weight into your front leg as you pull your heel back. Inhale. Exhale, warrior two, cartwheel your hands open, pause here and breathe. Reach your arms apart from one another as you take your gaze over your front fingers. Pull your legs apart, zip your abdominals in. Find patience in your mind and patience in your body. Maybe you're starting to feel your front leg burn a little bit. It's okay, we're almost there. Inhale, star pose, turn both heels in. Exhale, interlace your fingers behind you. Try the opposite grip, so whatever feels comfortable, and then do the opposite. And then pull your fingers back behind you, this time without the arch in your spine. Zip your core together and pull your knuckles back. We're gonna do some neck circles, so drop your chin towards your chest. Roll your chin to your right shoulder. Drop your right ear over your right shoulder. Lift up and over to the left side. Drop your left ear to the left. Drop your chin to your chest. And roll once more to your right. Drop your right shoulder down, right ear down. Yikes. And then up and over to your left shoulder. Turn your nose down to center and twice to your left. Reach your chin to your left, drop your left ear down, lift up and over, right ear drips down, turn nose to your right. I'm just gonna stop talking. One more to your right. Yikes, yikes, yikes. And it's to your left, actually. Oh man, words are hard. And then slowly release, inhale, star pose, reach your arms high. Exhale, wide-legged forward fold, turn your toes in, fold over your legs, let your head relax. Good. This time, see if you can widen your feet a little bit so the top of your head, the crown of your head can reach down. Remember last time we talked about where the top of your head is. And if you need to pause, you can let your thumbs touch the crown of your head, or excuse me, your temples, and then your fingers will overlap, and where your index fingers are or your middle fingers, that's where you want your weight to be. So see if you can let your head just touch the ground, pull your elbows in and really push your hands into the ground. This active press into your hands will take a little pressure off of your neck. And if you grip your fingertips into the ground and you really push into your hands, you'll start to feel your arms get a little tired. Hold for a few more breaths. Good. One more inhale. And then exhale, push your hands into the ground as you roll up. Inhale, star pose, reach your arms high. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, reverse warrior, push your knee forward as you reach your left arm back behind you, soften in your shoulders, zip your lower abdominals in, relax in your neck. You can look up towards the ceiling, you can look straight in front. Maybe if you want a little stretch for your neck, you can look down. One more inhale. And then exhale, cartwheel your hands down. Your choice, move through your flow or straight to downward facing dog. We'll meet in a downward facing dog. No pressure, whatever feels comfortable for you. Inhale, bend both knees, gaze forward. Exhale, malasana squat, walk, step, or lightly hop to the top of your mat. Elbows are on the inside of your knees. Lift your chest nice and tall. Stay active in your glutes and your hamstrings. Good. And then inhale, plant your hands down. Yogi's choice, exhale, walk, step, or jump into your chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, float your right leg high. Exhale, right knee to right elbow, pause here. Squeeze your heel towards your butt. Lift your knee as close to your armpit as possible. Yes, so really pushing in and scooping under. Hold and breathe for 4, 3, 2, inhale, stay. Exhale, low lunge. So instead of lifting your leg, you just shift your foot forward, and you might need to grab your ankle and help it get there. That's fine too. Inhale, crescent lunge, reach high. Exhale, airplane arms, extend your arms back behind you, lean forward. Inhale, reach your arms forward so your biceps frame your ears. Hold here. Pull your fingers as far forward as you can, zip your lower abdominals and push your left heel back behind you. One more inhale. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, star pose, turn your heels in. Exhale, wide-legged forward fold, turn your toes in, let your head relax down. Good. This time, bring your hands to your mat and bring your head to the top of your head down to your mat, if that feels comfortable. Squeeze your elbows in, press your hands down into the ground, and then try and take the same relevés we took before, lifting up onto your heels for 4, or excuse me, lifting up onto your toes. Try not to roll the weight. It's not like you're gonna do a somersault. You really want your arms to engage. Last 2. And last 1. Good. Inhale, bend your knees. Exhale, roll up, let your head relax. Inhale, star pose. Take your time to roll up. Exhale, warrior 2. Inhale, reverse warrior. Exhale, low lunge, cartwheel your hands down. Your choice, your flow. We'll meet in downward facing dog. And you can skip the flow and go straight to downward facing dog, always an option. Good. Inhale, lift your left leg high. Exhale, left knee to left elbow. Squeeze your heel towards your butt and see if you can lift your knee just a little higher towards your armpit. Really push your hands into your mat, grip your fingertips down. One more inhale. Exhale, low lunge, step your left foot through. Inhale, crescent lunge. Exhale, airplane arms, pull your chest forward as you reach your fingertips back behind you. Good, and then inhale, sweep your arms forward so your biceps frame your ears. Zip your lower abdominals in, try not to arch in your back. Inhale, exhale, warrior 2. Inhale, star pose, turn your heels in. Exhale, wide-legged forward fold. Good. This time we're going to do a little handstand drill, or really a tripod drill. So bring your hands down to your mat underneath your shoulders. Hug your elbows, and as you slowly lower the top of your head down to your mat. Now, if you feel like this is where you need to be, then pause. If it feels comfortable, walk your feet to touch. So squeeze your inner thighs and hold it here. Good. If this feels like enough, stay here. If you want to lift just one leg up, you'll hold for four. Just one leg, doesn't matter which one. Three, really lift your toes up, squeeze your arms in, and lower your right, whatever leg you lifted. And then lift the opposite leg. Squeeze and hold. Lift one heel up, 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 up. Press your hands down, hold three, two, and slowly lower down. And then walk your feet out wide once again. And lift your head off of your mat. Bend your knees. Look at your belly button. Exhale. Slowly roll up one vertebrae at a time. Take your time. Inhale, star pose. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, reverse warrior. Exhale, cartwheel your hands down. Your choice to flow or straight to downward facing dog. Good. Inhale, bend both knees, gaze forward. Exhale, malasana squat, walk, step, or lightly hop to the top of your mat. Good. Option to stay here for a few more breaths. Option to go into crow for a few breaths. We'll be here for three breaths exactly. So if you want to do crow, turn your toes parallel, pull your knees in towards your armpits as close as you can, and then hit crow, or stay in malasana squat and take a few breaths. Remember, for your crow, grip your hands into your mat. Try and pull your chest forward. It's just a gentle shift of your weight. One more inhale. And yogis who are in crow, if you want to jump into chaturanga, you can, or you can step back. Yogis who are in malasana, your choice. You'll make your way into chaturanga. And then inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Yes, beautiful choices, yogis. Good. Downward facing dog is where we meet. Inhale, float your right leg high. Exhale, right knee to right armpit or as close as it can go. Inhale, exhale, low lunge. Inhale, crescent lunge, sweep your arms high. Exhale, warrior three. So your arms keep towards your ears, you shift forward and you float your left leg off of the ground. Flex your left foot and really pull through your heel. Reach your arms as far forward as you can. So it's like you're in a T position. Yes, if you want to bring your arms to the side or back behind you for airplane variation, you're welcome to. Whatever helps you keep your balance. One more inhale. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, star pose. Exhale, wide-legged forward fold. Option to stay here for three breaths, or option to come into headstand or tripod. Your choice. We've been prepping tripod just because that's what we'll be doing with our crow from our crow pose. But if you feel more comfortable going into headstand, go for it. Or you can bring your legs together and take a breath with one leg up and then take a breath with the other leg up. Good. Nice, yogis. Either wide-legged forward fold, tripod, or headstand. Good. My yogis upside down, slowly start to make your way back down. Nice, good control, good. Inhale, bend your knees, relax your arms. Exhale, slowly roll up, tuck your chin to your chest, take your time. Let the blood drain back. Get this nice stretch for the back of your neck. Inhale, star pose. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, reverse warrior. Exhale, cartwheel your hands down. Yogi's choice. Maybe you want a child's pose for a breath. Maybe you want to flow. Maybe you want to hold your plank and then shift back. Lots of options here. Listen to your body. Good. Inhale, lift your left leg high. Exhale, left knee to left armpit or as close as it can go. Inhale, take your gaze into the middle of your mat. Exhale, low lunge. Inhale, crescent lunge, reach your arms high. Exhale, warrior three, shift forward, keeping your arms by your ears and pull your right heel back behind you. Good. Option of your arms to the side or reaching your fingers back behind you for more of an airplane variation, whatever helps you keep your balance. If your fingers are extended out, think of one long line from your fingertips all the way to your heels. If your arms are in a different position, think crown of your head all the way back behind you. One more inhale. Exhale, warrior two, gently cartwheel your hands open. Inhale, star pose. Exhale, wide-legged forward folds. Inhale, bend your knees, look at your belly button. Exhale, slowly roll up one vertebrae at a time. Inhale, star pose. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, reverse warrior. Exhale, cartwheel your hands down. Your choice, your flow. We'll meet in a downward facing dog. If you want to rest in child's pose, that is always an option for you. Two breaths here. And then inhale, shift forward into your plank position. Exhale, drop down onto your knees and have a seat on your heels. All right, yogis, it is time. So you have the option to go crow, headstand, crow, chaturanga. Well, actually, crow, tripod, crow, chaturanga. You can go crow to chaturanga. You can go crow to headstand and back to crow. Take the time to explore and play and just remember patience. It might not happen today and that's okay. I'm just gonna zip my mouth and time for you to play. If you have questions, please feel free to either raise your hand or just unmute yourself and ask away. Happy to help, but I'm just gonna watch and observe. So whenever you're ready, you do what's best for you. Nice. Good. Be patient as to where you are today. Every day, your body is a little bit different. Be thankful to where you are today. Nice. Nice, Graziella. Be patient. Beautiful yogis, good choices. Nice, Claire, yes. Yes, a strong mama, yes. Nice, Erin, you got this. Grip your fingertips down, push, 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 push. Yes, 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 yes. Nice, yes, lovely. You got it, Katrina. Trust yourself. Yogis, you have a few more breaths to play. If you feel like you're done, you can rest in child's pose. Good. If you're not already in child's pose, you can make your way there now. Good. Take a few deep inhales, deep exhales. Maybe you want a more traditional child's pose with arms down by your side. And then slowly place your hands down, tuck your chin to your chest, take your time, roll up. Relax your arms by your side, just take a couple of circles in your shoulders. Be loose. Notice how your shoulders feel. And reverse the direction. And then shift your hips towards one side and swing your legs in front. If you have a yoga block, grab your yoga block and slide it underneath your knees. If you don't have a yoga block, just slightly bend your knees a little bit. Inhale your arms up towards the ceiling. Exhale, round your back, something I don't say too often, and grab your feet. And press your feet and your hands in towards one another. Let your head relax. Feel your spine really open here. Think about pulling your feet back to your shins, and you're pushing your toes forward at the same time, or really the balls of your feet forward. So in doing so, and if you really scoop your tailbone under, you'll feel a nice opening in your spine. Be gentle. One more inhale. And then exhale, slowly release. Take your time, come up. Slide your block out of your knees. If you had one, straighten your legs. Inhale your arms up towards the ceiling. This time exhale with a flat back, reach forward. Grab a hold of your feet if that's available to you, or you can relax your arms down by your side. If you're carrying a baby inside of you, you might want to widen your feet a little bit so there's room for your gorgeous belly to reach forward. You can also bend your knees if that feels more comfortable. One more inhale. And then exhale, slowly stack your spine. Good. We're gonna come into fish pose. So fish pose, we'll prep from the ground, but I'll just say real fast, your hands make a triangle position. So your thumbs touch and your fingers touch, more of a diamond shape actually. And you want the space that your hands are making to go right around your tailbone. Your elbows will pinch together and your shoulders will puff up towards the ceiling. So go ahead and roll onto your back all the way down to the ground. If hair is in the way, you might need to move it out of the way. And then make your fingers into that diamond shape and slide your hands underneath your tailbone. You can keep your knees bent or straighten your legs. Now start to walk your elbows in towards one another and reach, look back behind you. So you're trying to reach the crown of your head onto the ground as you pull your heart up towards the ceiling. Really big arch for your low back, arch for your whole back. Good, try and slide your elbows close towards one another. One more inhale. And then exhale, slowly unwind. Relax your hands. Pull your knees in towards your chest, gentle rock from side to side. Massage your spine. And then come into happy baby. Extend your feet up towards the ceiling. Option to take your two-piece fingers around your toes or hold onto the insides or the outsides of your feet. And push your tailbone down into the ground. Pull your chin towards your chest to help lengthen your neck. So you're really thinking of pressing your whole spine flat to the ground. So sometimes we focus on the widening of our legs in happy baby, but today I want you to focus on the length of your spine. So really activate your chin towards your chest to lengthen your cervical spine. Activate your abdominals to press your tailbone down and press your whole low back against your mat. So slightly more active happy baby than we normally do. One more inhale. And then exhale, slowly release. Option to hug your knees in, maybe shake your head no. And then bring your legs into a reverse tabletop position. Flex your feet and squeeze your inner thighs. Inhale your arms out towards the side in a T position. Keep your legs bent at a 90 degree angle as you tip your knees to your left side. Let your knees gently touch the ground. And then if you want to look away from your knees and look towards your right fingers, you can. If you want to hold on to your right leg, you can let your left hand come on top of your right leg. Try and soften your shoulders into your mat. Relax your neck. One more inhale. And then exhale, relax your arm if you're holding onto your leg. Slowly come back to center. Readjust to make sure your legs are in that 90 degree angle, knees stacked right over your hips. Inhale. Exhale, supine twist. Twist your knees over to your right side. And then look to your left. If you want to place your right hand on your left leg for a little extra guidance into your twist, you can. Few more breaths here. You try and release in your shoulders. And this is the time that our mind usually wanders as we're winding down our practice. Remember to have patience. As soon as you notice your mind wanders, let go of your thoughts. And pull your mind back to the present moment. One more inhale, and then exhale, slowly unwind. Hug your knees in towards your chest one last time. Option to curl yourself up into a nice tight ball. If there's any postures that you feel like you need to complete your practice, you can do that now. If you feel like your practice is complete, you can rest into your Shavasana, your corpse pose, your final pose of class. Option to have your legs extended straight. Option to bring your feet together and your knees wide into Supta Baddha Konasana. You can also come into fallen bridge where your feet are wide and your knees fall in. If you're feeling any pain in your low back, this is a good option for you, letting your knees fall in and your knees bent. Take a few breaths here. Notice how your body feels. And place your hands on your stomach. And start to breathe naturally and just notice how you can make your stomach move as you breathe. Sometimes we can breathe into our chest or our ribs. See if you can force your stomach into, or excuse me, force your breath into your stomach. And then keep one hand on your stomach and move one hand to your chest. And see if you can start your breath from your belly and feel it move up your stomach into your chest. So you'll first feel your belly lift. And you'll feel your breath move into your chest. And if you can feel your chest collapse first and then feel your belly collapse second, on your exhale, you'll feel your chest collapse first and your belly collapse second. Sometimes that's a harder one to get, so if it doesn't happen, that's okay. And I like to imagine that my breath is being poured into my body and I feel it fill up my belly, slowly filling up to my chest. And then my breath is being poured out. I feel it empty my chest first and then slowly empty down into my belly. Take a few more breaths like this, feeling the belly expand, then the chest expand, and feeling your chest collapse, and then your belly collapse. Relax your arms down by your side. Pause for another moment, letting go of your breath. If you're ready to move on and complete your practice, you can start to reach your fingertips overhead. Pull your fingers and toes away from one another. Maybe move your jaw around. And then whenever it feels comfortable, you can roll towards one side, letting your arm be your pillow. Take a moment on your side, a moment for stillness. And then use the strength of your arms to slowly push yourself up into a comfortable seated position. Your palms touch your breastbone. Or your palms touch and your thumbs touch your breastbone. Keep your eyes closed or your gaze soft. Take a moment to notice how your body feels, remembering how you felt in the beginning of your practice, and notice how you feel now. And softly bow your chin towards your chest. Thank yourself for making it to your mat. Thank yourself for having the patience mentally and physically for this beautiful practice. And bow forward. Thank the teacher in front of you and the teacher within you. Until next time, namaste. Thank you, yogis. I went a few minutes over. I apologize.